is known as longitudinal mode. So the values which we need to take here is, to measure the frequency, the equation is the previous one is the longitudinal mode, and now they are showing for transverse mode, and I'll show you how to take the measurements also later. Yeah, so see here, there is the rotation of the tuning fork. In this case, the tuning fork will vibrate perpendicular to the standing waves, the standing waves direction, or you can say here the length of the thread. Yes, so this is the equation to measure the frequency. Here we need to know the length of each loop and the tension of the string, the linear density, linear mass density of the string. Okay, so now I'm going to our explanation. Yeah, now once again I'll explain you what is a Meldes experiment. So see here, yeah, as I have shown in the previous video, so see here, there are two modes of vibrations we need to be produced in the tuning fork. One is longitudinal mode, and the second one is transverse mode. In the longitudinal mode, here it is the length of the string direction, and I'll show you. Yeah. So this is the length of the string direction, and in the same direction, the tuning fork is vibrating. So this is a longitudinal mode. The tuning fork vibration and the length of string is in the same direction. So this mode is known as a longitudinal mode or longitudinal drive mode, we can say. So in this mode, the frequency of tuning fork can be measured by using the equation F is equal to 1 by L into under root P by mu. Or as you all know, the tension which is producing in the string due to the weight suspended in this span. So the tension T is equal to mass into G, mg. So the weight of this pan will develop the tension in the string. So the tension T is equal to mg. So the frequency F is equal to the final equation to determine the frequency in the longitudinal mode is F is equal to square root gm by mu l square. So in this equation, g is acceleration due to gravity. So as you all know, g is an acceleration due to gravity, where m is mass which is suspended here, which means mass of the weight which we are adding here plus mass of the pan, and mu is the linear density, which is a constant. L is the length of each loop. So in this experiment, if you know the length of each loop, I am saying once again, in this experiment, if you know the length of each loop or the length of a standing loop, then you are able to calculate what is the frequency of tuning. So this is the procedure of an experiment, and this is the longitudinal mode. Now coming to the transverse mode, in case of transverse mode, the tuning fork will vibrate. So this is the direction of tuning fork vibration, and this is the length of the string. So you please see here that the vibration of tuning fork is perpendicular to the length of the string, so that this mode is known as transverse mode. And in this transverse mode, the equation to calculate the frequency of tuning fork is F is equal to G capital M by 4 mu L square. And this is the explanation or theory explanation of Meldes string experiment. Now I'm going to, so what I have just shown you in this video, the same physical how the lab apparatus are made in the physical lab, the same apparatus is set up in the virtual lab. Now I'm going to show you how that setup is meant, developed in that virtual lab. So now I will show you. Okay, so before going to that virtual lab setup, first I would like to introduce a website which is a very, very, very useful for all of our faculty. So the website is VLAB, very simple, vlab.co.in, vlab.co.in. V stands for virtual. So virtuallab.co.in is a very simple website, but which contains a very lot of virtual labs in different fields. So I'll show you, first I'll introduce you that what is the VLAB. Then I'll go to the MELDES virtual lab setup. Yeah. So this is VLAB's website, vlab.co.in, and which is initiated by Ministry of Human Resource and Development. First of all, a big thanks to MHRD for taking such a big initiative for VLABs. And see here, these are all the broad areas of virtual lab. Not only physics, you will find any virtual lab for any area. For example, in electronics and communication, in computer science and CSE, in EEE, the mechanical and civil, and all you see here, it is a civil. So almost all labs are available here. For example, if you go to the physical science, and if you go to the physical science, so again, all the experiments in which relates to physics are subclassified into several areas. So virtual lab, virtual astrophysics lab, and advanced analytic chemistry lab. And for example, if I go to optics virtual lab, someone has asked in yesterday class how we can do optics related labs by using virtual labs. So these are the optics related virtual labs. So you can do any lab which is available here. So you see here, you can do the angle of prism. You can do angle of prism lab, the experiment by using these virtual labs. And yeah, I'll show you the one more. So this is the subclasses of the physics. Yeah. And for example, coming to the harmonic motion lab. Yeah. That is coming. Yeah. So these are the experiments are available. So if I go to the laser and optics, let me go to modern physics lab. So if I go to modern physics lab, yeah, so these are the experiments are available. So you see here, there is a photoelectric effect, Millikan soil drop experiment you can do, and you can also do, you can also see the Hall effect experiment. So there are so many experiments are available here. You can just go to the vlab.co.in, and if you want, and then go to the physics, physical science, and then go to your related lab. And how to do this, how to do the virtual lab in this website, I will show you. And before that, I will show you one more. So if you want to know, or if you want to, if you want the only pure electronic based experiments, then what you need to do, you just go to electronics and communications and go to the basic electronics lab. Basic electronics lab. So go to the list of experiments. So see here. So all basic electronics related virtual labs are available. So all virtual labs are available. So for example, if you want to do the VI characteristics of diode, you can just click on it and you can do the experiment there. So this is all about what is a vlab.co.in. Now, by using this VLAB website, now I'm going to explain how the MELDES experiment is going to be operated, or going to be measured, are going to do. Yeah, I'll explain now how to do the MELDES experiment now. So I'm going to VLAB. Yes. So the Amrita, the value at the rate Amrita is some part of a VLAB where they have developed all physical science related experiments. So see here, there are sub classifications. Now, in my today lecture, I am going to explain the Meldes experiment. So, which is under harmonic motion and waves virtual lab. See here, the Meldes string operators. Yes. So this is the Meldes string operators experiment. So there are some sections here. So first they will give the theory of the experiment, which just now I have explained you the theory. If you want to know or if you want to study the theory, you can just go through it. So this is the theory of Meldes experiment. And then they will also mention here how to do the simulation. Here they will mention the procedure to how to do the simulation at the animation part or at the virtual lab setup. And after going through the theory and the procedure, we can self-evaluate here. So how much theory part you have understood in the theory, so that you can self-evaluate here and you can go to the simulation. So in the simulation, to run the simulation, they will ask to sign in. You can just click on sign in. You can just you can create your own username or password. But in a simple way, you can just click on Google. You can sign in with your existing Gmail account. It is an easy way to getting signed in to the virtual labs. So you can just select your email. Yeah. So initially it will ask to enable Flash Player. So if you are not enable the Flash Player, the animation will not work. So just to make sure that you have enabled your Flash Player in your browser. So how to enable the Flash Player? You just click on at this part. You please see here. This part will click. You can just click here, and here you can find the Flash Player. Here there are options. So initially, so it is in default. It may be in the black mode or ask mode. You just check. Put an allow so that the animation will work. So now coming to the experiment. So coming to the virtual lab experiment. So as just now I have shown you in the video. So here there is a setup of the tuning fork, which electrically mounted, and this is the voltage supply. And see here, initially it is in a longitudinal mode. Initially it is in a longitudinal mode. You can change to the transverse mode here. Okay. So this is the longitudinal mode. So first I will do the longitudinal mode, and then I will go to the transverse mode. And there are several tuning forks are available. You can select any one of the tuning fork. So now I am going with the tuning fork one. And so the major advantage of one of the major advantage in this virtual lab is, see here. Now I am doing the experiment on Earth surface, so that they have taken g is equal 9.8. So if I go to Uranus, so the G will be the 9.01. So without rocket or without any aeroplane, I can go to Neptune, Jupiter, or Uranus. So I can do the same experiment on there, on that surface. So that is a good thing. Anyway, so now here, by dragging this this arrow mark, you can add the weights to the pan. So here it is the pan. So you can add the weights to the pan. See here, mass in the pan. So initially it is a 5 grams. So if you drag here, so the masses will be added in the pan, and the transformer voltage initially it is 8 volt. I am not touching that. So, and this is a meter scale. So by adjusting a meter scale, so see here, see there, the meter scale will be this means the meter scale is moving on the string. The meter scale is moving on the string. Yeah, this is explanation about the experiment. Now I am going to start the experiment. So how to start the experiment? First I will select the longitudinal mode and tuning fork one. So I'm the experiment on Earth only. So the mass is initially 5 grams. So now you just click on power on. Yes. So they have given some sound effect. so that the tuning fork is start vibrating. So see here, the standing waves are forming. So standing waves are forming. Okay, yeah. So now what you need to do, you need to measure. First I'll explain and then I'll show you, because the sound is disturbing. Yeah, first, so what we need to do in this experiment, so after forming the standing waves, you need to measure the length of each loop. So by measuring the length of each loop, you can calculate the frequency of tuning fork by using the equation. If it is a longitudinal mode, by using this equation, you can calculate. So first, what we need to do, we need to calculate the length of each loop. So initially, I'm going with the 5 grams of mass. So yeah, now I will show you how to measure the length of each loop. So see here, the loop is forming here. First, place this line. Place this line to the one end of the loop. Yeah. Okay. So place this line at the one end of the loop and note down this value. So this is 1, 1.1, 1.11, 1.2, 1.3. So, and how to measure, hold a moment. Yeah. How to measure, just one moment, I'll show you. Yeah. So first I'll measure from here to here. This will give the L1. Next, I will measure from here to here, and this will give you the L2. And L2 minus L1, L2 minus L1 will give us the length of the loop. So first I need to note down what is the So first I'll note down, hold a moment. Yeah. So first I'll note down what is the L1. The L1 is 1.13. So I'm noting down manually. So 1.13. And what is an L2? I need to move. Yeah. First I need to move the line to the other end of the loop. Yeah, the L2 is 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, 1.49. So the L2 is 1.49. Let's stop. Okay. Now I'll enter these values in the table. So initially I have taken the mass of the pan is 5 grams. What is L1 which I have taken? 1.13. And what is an L2? 1.49. So see here, the length of each loop is 0.36, and for this cell I have already written the equation. So all of you please look at this here, look at here. So this is the equation which I have written this cell. So it is automatically calculated, and finally I got the frequency, I got the frequency of the loop of the standing wave is 60 hertz. The frequency of standing wave is 60 hertz. And one point that I forgot to show you. So see here, they have already mentioned what is the linear density of string and what is the mass of the scale pan, which means an empty pan. So that I have already added here. So see here, this is the linear density and this is mass of the empty pan. So by taking all these values and by taking the length of the loop for 5 grams. So after calculating, the frequency of the standing wave is 60 hertz and the theoretical value is also 60 hertz. So here we are 100% accurate for the 5 grams, let me say. And let me go to the 10 grams. So just power on and go to the 10 grams. Okay. Now again, you need to measure the length of the loop. So to measure the length of the loop, first let us adjust the loop. Okay. Now. So at the one end, the fun end, this is 1.3, 1.36, 1.37. So I am noting down manually 1.37, and to the other end, so 1.5, 1.6, 1.7, 1.8, 1.86. So 1.86. Okay. So for the 10 grams, let me power off. Yeah. So for the 10 grams, the L1 value means the length at the first end is 1.37. Length at the second end is 1.86. Enter. So see here, it is 61 H. So similarly, I have done for all the weights. All the weights. Yesterday, I have made. I have already do that experiment. For all that weights, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So for the time being, I will just copy these values and I will just paste there. Yeah. So copy and I will paste here. There is a mistake. So similarly, I have done the same experiment. I have done this experiment for different values or different values of mass which we are adding to the pan. So for each mass, I got the frequencies like this. So 60, 61, 62, 66, 62, and the average of 62. The theoretical value is 60. So the error percentage 3%. So this is how I have done the experiment in the longitudinal mode. So this is for longitudinal mode. Now I'll show you the same experiment how we can do in the transverse mode. Yeah. So hope you all clear in the longitudinal mode. Now I'm going to show you in transverse mode. First, you need to change the experiment to the transverse mode. So see here. Here it is. The experiment have shifted to the transverse mode. Now initially it is fixed. It is for 10 grams. Now initially it is fixed for 10 grams. And okay, yeah, now I'm just power on. So now the same way, so first move the cursor, first move the white line to the one end. So for the 10 grams, so the L1 is 1.5 1.6 1.61 62 63 64, so 1.64, and go to the other end. Yeah. And here 1.6788.5678, so 1.88. Just power off. Yeah. Coming to this Excel sheet. So for the 10 grams of weight, what is L1? 1.64, and what is L2? 1.88. Just click enter. So see here. The similarly which I have shown for the longitudinal mode. For the transverse mode also, this equation I have written for this cell. So the calculator frequency is 62. So that is for 10 grams. Now similar way, I have done the experiment for the other weights. So I will just copy and then I will paste here. Yeah. So see here. So for this, for each mass, I got the frequency of 62, 63, 65, 60, 63. So the average is 64, and the theoretical value is 60. So the error percent which I have obtained is 6%. So the 6% error is we can neglect actually. So in our regular lab, in our normal lab, we got approximately 10% of 10% of error. Usually we will got some 10% of error. So anyway, so this is how we can do the experiment, or we can do the Meldes experiment by using VLabs virtual website. So it is a very, very, very useful website for not only physics, for all branches, for all, which means for ECE, CSE, I mean for engineering, when you are coming for engineering. And if you come from, coming to the degree side, for almost all the chemistry people and computer science people, for all the people, almost all virtual labs are available there. So you please go and sign into vlab.co.in. You just remember vlab.co.in. This is very simple. And find your virtual labs and you can practice it. You can practice there. And the very good thing about the VLab is, it is a very free website. Yeah. So I'll show you. Yeah. It is first, it is free source. No need to give any rupees or anything. No need to spend a single rupee. There's a free website and no need to worry about it. And you can practice in n number of times and you can sign in freely. And the thing is, you need to know how to handle Flash Player. That is the only thing you may get some difficulty while using this VLab. If you have any doubt how to use, how to enable the Flash Player and how to handle the Flash Player, you can go and search in the YouTube, or you can ask any of your the friends or any colleagues which are more familiar with the Flash Player. That is the only thing you may feel some difficulty while handling the VLabs. So this is all about the VLabs, and so this is how this is the, sorry, this is the Meldes experiment. So finally, I have calculated the frequency of an AC source by using Meldes experiment. In case of longitudinal mode, it is 62 Hz. In case of transverse mode, it is 64 Hz. So I got less error percent in longitudinal mode, and I got a little more error percent in transverse mode. So this is all about Meldes experiments and VLabs website. Yeah. Okay. Now I'm going to the next experiment, that is the wavelength of a laser using diffraction grating. So yeah, first I'll show you what is the, okay. So this is the title of the experiment. So the wavelength of a laser using a diffraction grating. So in this experiment, what we will do, we will use a diffraction grating in between the laser beam, and the laser beam while passing through this diffraction grating, the great diffraction grating, it will get diffracted. So the diffraction pattern will be observed here on the screen, let me say. So by analyzing the diffraction pattern on the screen, we are able to calculate the wavelength of the laser. So before going in detail about this virtual lab, first I will show you how actually the same experiment is in general lab. Just I will show you a video, a small video. Just all of you please see the small video. So this is all about how the laser experiment is set up in our regular lab. So the diffraction grating is important and the laser is important, and the distance between diffraction grating and laser need to be varied, and we will measure the distances between the order of the diffractions. So before getting into in detail, first I'll show you. So the experiment is the wavelength of a laser using a diffraction grating, and here we are using a normal incidence method. So the diffraction or the laser beam incidenting on the grating perpendicular to its surface. So this is a normal incidence method, and the aim is to determine the wavelength of a given source of a laser using a plane transmission grating by normal incidence method. The equation we will use to measure the wavelength is lambda is equal to sine theta by small n into capital N, and the output of the wavelength is in a nanometer. So where L is the wavelength of the laser source, N is the number of lines per mm. Here I am taking for mm, because in our virtual lab setup, the grating which I have chosen is they have given in mm. So the number of lines per mm, and the small n represents the order of diffraction. Theta is the angle of diffraction. So this is actually how a diffraction grating looks like, and this is the basic definition of the diffraction pattern. So usually how we define the diffraction, so the diffraction is the bending of light at an obstacle. So the bending of light at an obstacle while it is passing. So what is the diffraction grating? So here on the diffraction grating, we made some number of slits or some n number of slits. So before going to the diffraction grating in detail, first we need to know what is a slit. The slit is a small opening portion while traveling the light. When the light traveling through the small opening of a portion, that small opening of portion is known as a slit. And the small opening, the length of the small opening must be compared to the wavelength of the incident light, so that the diffraction pattern can be observed. So first I will show you how the light is diffracted through the multiple slits, then I will show you the diffraction grating lab. So first I will show you how the diffraction will happen when the light passes through multiple slit, then I will show you the laser diffraction. So this is the diffraction pattern, and here we can adjust the spacing, which means a small portion, small opening portion. And initially I have chosen for the incident radiation, and for example, if I keep one gap, which means the light is diffracting through a single slit. So how the pattern is formed? Here I am showing the pattern which is formed when the light is diffracting through a single slit. So a single intensity will form on the screen. So this is how the diffraction pattern is formed on the screen when it is diffracted through one gap. For example, if I select it to the two gaps, so this is the diffraction pattern. For example, if I go to the 10 gaps, so this is the diffraction pattern when the light is diffracted through 10 gaps, which means 10 slits. So this is the diffraction pattern. So this is the central maxima, and this is the first maxima, and this is second maxima, and so on. And this is central bright thing. So this is how the diffraction or the light will be diffracted when it is passed through the n number of slits. So this is how the diffraction is formed. Now I'm going to explain the diffraction virtual lab setup. So before going to explain, first let me explain the virtual lab setup. So as I'm showing here the diagram, here it is a laser source. So in between the laser source, the diffraction grating will be inserted. So after the laser beam traveling through the diffraction grating, diffraction pattern will be observed on the screen. So in our relation, the small n and capital N we can calculate directly from the experiment, but the sine theta we need to be determined, or sine theta we need to be measured. So how to get the sine theta? First I'll show you. So how to get the sine theta, then I'll first I'll show you how to get the sine theta, and then so coming to here, so let me say this is the laser source, and in between the laser source we are inserting the grating. So we are inserting the grating, and on the screen, the diffraction pattern is observed. Now what I am doing, so how to measure the sine theta. So this is a right angle triangle, and here it is a theta, and this is the distance between grating and the screen. This is represented with the capital D, and this represents with the small d. The small d which represents the distance between central maxima to if I say the first order is a d1, this is d. And if you know, if you want to know what is the sine theta, as you all know, what is the sine theta? Opposite by hypotenuse. The opposite means this is small d, and hypotenuse which means this is hypotenuse. So hypotenuse is, the value of hypotenuse is d square plus small d square. This is hypotenuse. So if you know, and initially we will fix the capital D. Initially we will fix the capital D, which means the distance between grating and screen we will fix initially, and we will measure the small d, which means the distance between central maxima to the first maxima. By knowing the small d, and we will calculate the sine theta, and after calculating the sine theta, we will substitute the sine theta in this equation, and then you will get to know what is the wavelength of the incident radiation. And so this is the introduction for the virtual labs, the lab setup. Now I am going to the virtual lab setup. So one moment, it is loading. Yeah, so this is a virtual lab setup. So see here, this is a laser beam, and here it is a grating. Initially the grating is not inserted, so the beam is directly incidenting on the screen without a diffraction. So without a diffraction, I'm saying. So yeah, so if I insert the grating, the light beam will be diffracted, and I'll show you how we can insert the grating. And here there are three options. Here the lens to grating distance we can change here. So see here, if I change this distance, the screen is moving, and you can choose any grating element in between 200 to 500. So initially it is 300, you can fix it. And not and here the other advantage, here you can select any color. So in between 400 to 700 nanometer you can choose any color. Usually we will do with the red laser, so I am selecting to the red laser. Yeah, okay. So now okay, now what I will do, first I will insert the grating. So see here, by clicking here, grating in place. See here, please observe one second. So see here, so when I am inserting the grating, the laser beam is diffracting. So hope you all, so see here, when I am inserting the grating, the laser beam is diffracting, and the beam, the orders are forming here, and I'll go with the red laser. Okay, so this is the red laser, this is the diffraction pattern of red laser, and this is the central maxima, this is first maxima, and this is again first maxima. This side is LHS, this side is RHS. I'll show you, wait a moment, just I'll reduce the size so that you can easy to. Okay, okay. Now, so now I'll also reduce the screen to grating distance so that more diffraction patterns can be observed. So see here, so okay, so okay, yeah, so this is, let me say, LHS. And this is, let me say, RHS. and this is central maxima. Central maxima or n is equal to zero, and this is say the first order, and this is second order, and this is third order. And let me say this is first order, and this is second order, and this is third order. And what we need to do? We need to measure the distance from central maxima to the first order. Let me say this is the D1, and this is for LHS side. And coming to the RHS, this is let me say D2. So what is the value here? It is around 1.1. So go to your Excel sheet. So here, for the which order we are observing? We are observing for first order. So one D1 is, which means LHS side D1 1.1 and RHS D1 1.1. Just enter. Hold a moment. Okay, the average is 1.1. Okay, so see here, the wavelength has calculated. So the same equation, I have written this equation for this cell. So it is 716 nanometer. So the distance we need to be check once again. The distance of the screen here is just 5. Where it is 5 or not? So 5 only. And the grating element number is 300. Okay. So 5 and 300. So I have just substituted all these values in this equation. So I got the wavelength of the laser is 716 nanometer. Now I will go to the second order. So for the second order, so this will be the D1. And for the second order, and from here to here it is D2. Okay, so the D1 is 2.123. So 2.3. Just enter 2.3. So we are observing for second order. Enter the D1 is 2.3. And again 2.3. Sorry, 2.3. So the wavelength is 697. Now I'll go to the third order. So this is the D1, and from here to here it is D2. So for the third order, the D1 is 4.1. So go to Excel. So for the third order, the distance is 4.1 and 4.1. So the average is again 4.1. So 705. So the average of these three values is 706. So the standard wavelength is 700 nanometer. You see here. So the standard wavelength is 700 nanometer. So see here, the standard wavelength is 700 nanometer, and from our experiment, we obtained the wavelength is 706. So the error percent is just 0.8, not even 1% error we got. So this is how we can do the laser experiment, laser diffraction experiment, by using a virtual lab. And first, this virtual lab setup is not available in VLab. Then what is this website? First, I'll introduce what is this website and what is this website. So you please here, if all of you please look at here. The website name is GeoGebra. And then I'll introduce you what is this website is. Okay, so you just remember the name GeoGebra.org, GeoGebra.com.org. So what is this website? I'll show you, and how this website is useful for us also I'll show you. Hold a moment, it is coming. Loading. Sorry, this. Yeah. So the GeoGebra is a website. Yeah. So see here, this is a website, GeoGebra, where you can create your own animations. So once again, I'm saying you can create your own animations, but little difficult it is. So how you can create here it is, here you need to give mathematical equations for physical behavior. So in that way you can create your own animations. So for example, I'll show you some animations, and you just go to, if you are very new to this website, you just go to geogebra.org and search here for physics. So search here for physics. So there are so many animations are available here, and most of the animations are suitable for +2 and the degree level, and yeah, intermediate and degree level. For example, I'll show you one equation for. So for example, this animation. So this is the animation. Hold a moment, I'll show you. It's not loading yet. Hold a moment. So for example, coming to the physical pendulum, so see here, this is a physical pendulum. So if you click on animation, so see here how the physical pendulum is. So you can change here the mass of the object. Yeah, the same thing will come to here. So this is how the behavior of a physical pendulum. So something like this, you will find n number of animations which already have prepared by someone else, and you can use it freely, and no need to subscribe or no need to pay any amount. And you can also create your own animations, something like this, but it will take some time. I'm trying since 1 month. I'm in starting stage. So for example, I'll show you on a small, as I said, I'm just a learner. So please excuse me if I'm not reaching to your estimation, or I'm not reaching you. So I'll just show you how you can create an animations. For example, I'll show you. So go to GeoGebra Classics. And as you all know, y is equal to ax square, which represents the parabolic path. I'll just write that equation here. So y is equal to ax square. So just click enter. So this is the parabolic path. Okay. So this is the parabolic path with a variable of a. So if I click the animation, so see here, the animation will be developed, or animation will be appeared here. So, and this is how a parabolic path will be varied with respect to the parameter a. This graph show you how the parabolic path will be varied with respect to the constant a. So in this way you can create your own animations in this website, or you can search for your experiment also. So for example, if you want to search for RC circuit, you can search for it. So see here, here it is an RC circuit. So this is an RC circuit. So for example, if I close the switch, this is the discharging mode. If I open the switch, this is charging mode. This is for an RC circuit. So similarly, you can find so many animations which are related to physics. And this is a simple RC circuit. I will show you one once. Okay. So this is how the charging and discharging for an RC circuit. So by showing these animations, you can explain to the students also. Okay. So this is all about what is GeoGebra. And again, it is a free source. you can download it, or you can try in the website also. So in this GeoGebra only, I took that laser diffraction experiment. I'll show you laser diffraction. So this is a diffraction grating laser experiment. So some other other animations also available, but this is more convenient for us, and this is a similar or exactly how we will do in our regular lab. Yeah, so this is what the GeoGebra is, and the major advantage of this virtual lab, and this especially for this laser virtual lab, as you could see, as you have seen in the video, they have given an first instruction or precaution that you should not see the laser directly, but here you can play with the laser actually. So this is the first major advantage. And the virtual labs, we can play with the virtual labs, but in the general physics lab there is some limitations anyway. For each setup there are some positives and negatives anyway. So this is how, what a GeoGebra, and how you can do, how you can search for your own virtual labs. If available, you can do it, you can use it, and if not available, you can search in another sources. And the important thing that I want to say about the GeoGebra is there are some plenty number of animations are available which relates to physics, which are most useful to intermediate and degree physics students and faculty also, for the effective explanation, for effective teaching. That is the thing. Yeah, so this is all about the laser experiment. And then finally, just a more 10 to 20 minutes I'll wind up the session. So finally, I would like to show you a website, I would like to show you a software, a software named AlgaDo, AlgaDo, AlgaDo. It is a free software, and in this software you can create your own virtual animations. That is a good thing. So this is a free software, you can create your own animations. So for example, I'll do with an example, I'll show you one example. For example, I want to show a simple pendulum experiment to my students. So that simple pendulum experiment now I'll create here. So how to create that simple pendulum experiment, I'll show you. So, and first I'll briefly introduce this website. So here it is, the website, and these are all the login files to the website, to the software, and these are all the tools to create the objects in this plane, and this is circles, and these are all the tools which we need to use for the instruments. Anyway, first, to create a simple pendulum, first I need to create a bob. So I'll select a circle tool, and then I'll create a circle. Sorry. Okay, now I'll create a circle. Yeah. Okay, now usually in our lab we will use a steel bob. So here there are several options. So you can change the material type to any type. So for example, if you want to use a steel bob, you can select a steel. And if you want to use a stone, you can select a stone. Or if you want to use a wood bob, you can select for wood. So usually we will use steel bobs in our lab. So I'm going with the steel. Now I need to tie this bob. So I need a rope. So I'm going to the rope. Yeah, I'm attaching the rope here. Okay, so now I have attached the rope. Okay, so now what I need to do, after creating the seam or after adding all the components which are required, you need to click on play button. So here it is, a play button. Hold a moment. So see here, you just click the play button so that it will start moving. So I'll just select a drag tool. I'll just drag to some distance and then I'll leave it. So see here, the pendulum is oscillating. For example, if you want to know how the forces are acting on the pendulum, how the force directions are acting on the pendulum, you just right click it, go to the velocities and show the forces and momentum, or let me set the velocities also. So click the play button. So see here, this is how the velocity and momentum is varied to that bob, to that pendulum, let me say. And for example, if you want to analyze the motion of that bob, you can just right click on it and go to show plot. So this will show you the graph. So this will show you the graph. Initially it is showing time versus speed. Let me say, click the play. So see here, this is the time versus speed graph. For example, if I want to change the velocity versus time. So this is how the velocity is varied with respect to graph. For example, I want to change the position versus velocity. So this is how the graph, if you plot a position versus velocity. And for example, if I want to graph, if I want to plot the graph, position versus, let me say, energy. And as you all know, the energy is conserved, which means the total energy must be conserved. For example, if I plot the graph, energy. Yeah. And potential energy. And let me add the kinetic energy. So this is the position versus, let me say, if I plot the graph, time, position. This is how the energy versus position graph. And let us come to the initial part. Okay. So this is the position versus time graph. And the good thing about this software is, so see here, you can save this as an image file. You can save this entire graph as an image file, or you can download as a CSV file. CSV, which means an Excel sheet. So you can download as an Excel sheet and you can do whatever you want with that data. So which means it is almost equal to how we are doing the experiment in the lab and how we are exporting the data from the lab. So this is how we can create a simple pendulum by using this Algado software. Once again, I'm saying it is a free software. And hold a moment. Okay, so it is a free software. And again, here you can play with the physics. And all the objects which are creating here will be behaved as an object in our real life. So the objects which we are creating here are similar to our real life. For example, if I convert all this into water, so see here. So this is how the water is moving on the surfaces of rocks, let me say. So this is how we can create our own animations in a simple way. No need a complicated softwares, no need a complicated programs. You just need to know how to create the objects in a simple way. And you can play with the physics here also. And it is a free software. You try this. And both Windows and Mac versions are available. And it is available only in the desktop or the laptop. I think it's not available in the phones. Yeah. And one more I would like to show you. And if you want to know, for example, if you don't know how to create all these in this website initially, you can just directly go to the load scenes. In the load scene, there are already pre-created animations are available here. So these are all the animations which I have already created. You can go through these animations and you may get some idea how to create the animations. So for example, I'll go with this animation. So this is the rainbow, how the rainbow is formed, as you all know, how the rainbow is formed. So this is how the rainbow is formed, and this is a laser beam. So this is how the rainbow is formed. I'll load you one more. So if I go with this prism, so see here, this is a prism. As you all know, when the light passes through the prism, it will get dispersed. So this is how the light will be dispersed, and this is how the concave lens behaved, and this is how the concave lens behaved. This is a convex lens, so this is concave lens. So what you can do here, you can play with the physics here. And the important thing here, so generally in our lab, we need to be handled with the care these glass type materials. But here, no need to worry. You can do anything with this glass material. Nothing will happen. So this is the good thing with this software. And yeah, there are so many animations are available. So this is something like Brownian motion. So as you all know, what is a Brownian motion? The multiple collision of atoms and how the atoms will be moved from one place to the another place. This is the Brownian motion. So something like this. So what finally I would like to say, the physics is a subject where we can understood by practical, more where we can understood well by using practical analysis. So that's the thing we can do here. So this is all about this website. Okay, so finally, yeah, so in our 2-day session, in our e-workshop 2-day session, so I try to introduce these 4 websites, these 3 websites and this software. So the first is the tinkercad.com, vlab.co.in, geogebra.org and Algado. And coming to the hands-on experience, the Tinkercad will be the first place. And coming to the availability, or more number of labs availability, the VLab is number one. So, and if you want to create your own animations, so if you don't want to use, or if you get rid of all these already created experiments, you can just go to the GeoGebra and Algado. You can create your own animations and your own experiment. So, hold a moment. Yeah. So if you have any doubt, or if you want to interact with me on any of these regards, you can directly contact me on this phone number 7981417854, or you can write to my email panthakan.raju@gmail.com, or you can follow my channel youtube.raju360360. Okay. And this is my YouTube channel, where I have uploaded some of interesting physics videos. So see here, these are all videos which I have created by using an Algado, which just now I have explained, you know, this software. By using this software, I have created all these the videos. You can follow my YouTube channel also. So thank you. Thank you one and all for patient listening. So thank you. And
hello. Thank you, Raju sir. Dr. Raju sir. Now this is the time. Okay, sir. Continue.
Okay. Sorry, please carry on.
Now this is the time for question and answer session. Yes, I request from participants, do you have any doubts? Please raise your hands. From our side, we are ready to unmute you. Hemant. Hemant, please unmute yourself. Dr. K. Kandas Bhapati. Hello, sir. Sir, please. Already we unmuted. Please ask your query. Hello. Dr. K. Ganka Swapati.
Sir, you can give the participants to unmute themselves, sir.
Sir, already we unmuted, sir.
So participants, you can unmute yourself and you can ask
the question. Good afternoon, sir.
Yes.
Good afternoon.
Sir, this is very informative session.
Yes, sir.
We have doubt about suppose all the electronic experiments, digital electronics and analog electronics experiments, can be possible to carry out this software like GeoGebra.
I think we cannot do electronic based experiments. For electronic based experiment, you can go to VLab, sir. VLab.codatom.
VLab.codatom.
Okay. There, the large number of electronic based experiments are available.
Since I am asking, during the lockdown period, we cannot able to conduct lab experiments. So maybe possible next month itself, theory class will be started. So lab also we can able to conduct via this app, no? It's possible.
Yes, sir. It's possible. We can connect. You can make a video call and you can share the screen and you can conduct the labs.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Any other participants?
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes.
Good afternoon.
Yeah, I am Ramesh Kumar from Sujata College, Hyderabad, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, yesterday you explained about the Thinkercad labs, no, sir?
Yes, sir.
In that, we can able to do with the VHDL experiments, very high description language, software program experiment is possible.
No, sir, you do one thing. You just log into the Thinkercad.
Yeah.
And just redirect to your workplace. And you just search for your components.
Okay.
If the components are available, it is definitely possible to do any lab.
Okay, sir.
You need to know whether your components are available or not.
Okay.
If the components are not available, if you are unable to create your virtual lab, you just go to the vlab.codatom.
Okay.
There you may find the virtual lab setup.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thank you for your information.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. K. Kanaga Subhapati. Any queries from participant side? Hemant.
So
yes, Dr. Vijayalakshmi, sir. Ma'am, cutting.
Yeah. Yesterday you were talking about the Thinkercad. That is free or it should be installed in your
No, ma'am, no need to install any software. It is a web-based link.
Okay. Once we complete the experiment, we cannot save it or we cannot make use of it for the future
ma'am, once you create an experiment, that will be automatically saved on your dashboard.
Okay.
That can be shared to your students also.
Okay. So without the software, how is it working? It doesn't need any software or...
Thinkercad, no need any software.
Okay.
It is just a web tool.
Okay. So without you can create the experiment, you can perform the experiment and the whole thing will be saved and it will be retrieved and we can make use of it n number of times without the software. That is what you are saying.
Yeah,
okay. Without this one. So nice. Very nice, sir. Your presentation was very nice. Thank you.
Thank you. Shanmugaraju.
Hello. I am Dr. Shanmugaraju from Aralanandar College.
Yes, sir. Sir, tell me, sir.
Sir, I have a few doubts.
Yes, sir. Please ask me.
First one, if anybody do the experiment... in the online, all of them will get the same result, is it, sir?
Sorry?
If anybody does the experiment in the online,
MunLand means in the Tinkercad or some other?
Tinkercad,
no one will, what I'm saying, when you are logged into your website, into your account, which means you are doing it your account only. It not will affect to any other person which are logged at the same time.
So all the students will get the same result?
If they have done the same way, which means you are talking about how to form the classrooms in the Tinkercad?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. For that case, in that case, first students need to connect all the circuits, and that circuits can be accessed by the teacher. So that the teacher can see all the student circuits, and you can edit the circuits, you can resubmit to them.
I see.
So if you have any doubt, please go to the YouTube. And you please check the classroom in Tinkercad. You will find a video.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Another doubt, sir.
Yeah.
Is there any advanced experiments like on thin film based experiments, sir?
Thin film based experiment, you please search in VLAB, sir. If not available, let us see, sir. I'll try to find any other website. If okay. I know, I'll definitely share in the YouTube.
Okay, okay.
Check my YouTube channel.
The more PG students are interested in thin films experiment.
Okay, sir. Definitely, I'll try to get to know what is how we can use the thin films virtual labs.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Yes, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, thank you.
Ma'am, your mic muted.
Yeah, thank you. As you said in Elgato, as we're doing animation, so simultaneously we can take the class, right, sir?
Yes, ma'am, you can.
Can we record our teaching, sir, along with the animation?
Better use in the system settings, ma'am. So in the laptop, there is an option to screen record. You can record it.
Okay, but in this app, the inbuilt is not there, sir, programming to record?
No, there is no inbuilt record option.
Okay, so only screen recording.
Yeah, you can use the screen record option in the laptop available. Nowadays, there are so many options for screen record.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, somebody is asking. They want softwares and website names, sir.
I have already mentioned, sir. I'll show you once again the slide.
Yes, sir. Once, if possible, you please show your slide, sir.
Yeah, I'll show you once.
They want for sharing purpose.
Okay, no problem, sir. I'll share the everything. You please note down all these, sir. You can ask the participants to.
I request all participants, please note down. Sir, he has already shared the screen. They are mentioned the websites. And sir, mobile number, email IDs. Do you have any queries? Please contact sir, no problem.
It's audible, sir.
And YouTube channel also there for sir.
You can check my channel for Elgato related videos. I have made some videos to Elgato for the Elgato. You can check my channel.
Sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, continue.
You were talking about that Arduino and you told that and not Elgato, that Tinkercad, in that you were talking about the Arduino. How it was working and what is the program language which they use. Is it C?
I don't know exactly, ma'am, but just as I said, I am very new to the electronics. Actually, I am the pure physics person.
Okay. I'm also physics. That's why I'm asking about it. Because we are supposed to handle PG classes, and that too we have to go for microprocessor and microcontrollers, all those programmings and C programming also. So I thought that if it is available in that Tinkercad to do all those things, making use of this Arduino and all, then it will. Okay. That is
right. I don't know, ma'am, exactly. Anyway, you can just ask. Some many Arduino experts. How they will write the program, you can write.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Next, Kanagavalli.
For the previous question, what is the language to Arduino program? So some of the participants are mentioning here, it is the C program.
C++
or C? You can use C++ or C. Thank you. Some of the carriers.
Nirmal Kumar. Nirmal Kumar R. Next, any queries from participants?
Yeah, someone is asking here, the Nirmal Kumar R is asking, is there any software that can be used with laptop alone without internet? The Algado does not require any internet, sir. Once you installed in your laptop, you can use without internet.
Nirmal Kumar is unable to unmute itself.
Algado.
Nirmal Kumar.
Is there any queries?
Dr. P.K. Sharma.
Sir, I want to know that is AC or DC source is used in Melody experiment?
Sorry?
Is AC or DC source is used in Melody experiment?
In which experiment, sir? I'm not getting. Sorry.
Hello?
Hello, yes, sir.
Are you listening to me?
Yes, sir, I'm listening.
I am asking that in Melody's experiment, DC or AC source is used, or both can be used?
AC source can only be used, sir.
Because in circuit diagram, you have made a battery, DC battery, DC source.
No, sir. In the video you're asking, or in the presentation you're asking, in the wheeler? If I use a DC source, I think we cannot produce vibrations in the tuning fork.
But in your circuit diagram, you have shown a battery.
No, sir. Actually, I think it is by mistake anyway. So usually we need to use an AC source, no, sir?
Okay, sir. Okay.
Thank you.
It's K. Vandana Devi. Nirmal Kumar.
Sir, Nirmal Kumar query is over, sir.
Next, Vandana Devi. Ma'am. Sir, I think so. Queries are over, sir. There is no queries from participant side.
Okay, sir. We'll conclude the session.
Shall we conclude, sir? Thank you, sir. Thank you for creating awareness regarding GeoGebra, Algado, and VLabs and Tinkercad related softwares. Thank you very much, sir, for spending valuable time with us. We are expecting same continuity from our college side also. In future also, we are expecting same type of friendly environment, like such type of sessions from your side also.
Sure, sir.
Now I am requesting Mr. Poonachandra P to give vote of thanks.
Thank you, sir. On behalf of Physics and Electronics Department, I would like to thank our distinguished speaker, Dr. Raju Pantagani, for excellent presentation and making this today e-workshop meaningful. And we also thank you very much, sir, for updating us on virtual labs as your talk was very commendable. And we all have certainly learned a lot over the course of these 2 days. We got to know about these online assets, which enhances the proximity between teacher and the students. And I would like to extend my sincere thanks to our principal, Dr. Vishwanathan Bulisu, for his support and guidance in all phases of this workshop. And I would like to thank our Vice Principal, J. Hari Prasad, and IQAC Coordinator, Dr. Ravi Kiran, for technical support. And I would like to thank all the delegates of this program for showing their interest to participate in this e-workshop. I thank all the department members for making this workshop a grand success. Once again, thank you very much to one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you all.